Today we're going to replace this flexible hose that goes between my Hayward pump and my Intex sand filter. So we're going to have to create a custom fitting up here, and it's all going to be hard PVC plumbing. Stay tuned. Save this. So here's our flexible pipe removed. Before we throw it away, we're actually going to cut it in half and remove these 40 millimeter nuts. These are the basis for how we create our custom PVC to Intex 40 millimeter fitting. The next piece you're going to need to source is this reducer bushing. This one's made by Dura. It's 1.5 to 1.25. It's schedule 40 PVC. And it's going to essentially slide into a 1.5 inch coupling connector. But what we'll do is we'll actually drop it inside of our nut. And we'll glue this reducer bushing into the connector with this still floating. So this nut doesn't get glued down, it's got to stay spinning. If you're having a hard time finding this particular reducer bushing, you can also use this one by Carlone. This is actually in the hardware store aisle where they have the various fittings for conduit. As will this conduit fitting. In each case, you'll have to sand the face of it flat. This one, you'll have to sand off these little nubs. But any of these three will work just fine. So we're just going to take a few minutes and sand this guy down. Gonna hit it a little bit more, but it's flat. All the words that were embossed into that flat surface are gone now. Nice and smooth. Should be ready to go. So I've already got my reducer bushing inside of the nut. I don't want to forget to do that, because once this is glued in there, you're not taking it back out. So I'm just gonna put glue into the inside of this PVC connector, and then I'll push the other bushing in so it gets pretty far down in there, but I want to keep the nut able to spin. It's got to be able to spin so that it ends up being working like a union. All right. So that's in there pretty good. I've still got the ability to spin the nut. Just gonna let that glue dry and keep the nut away from it. And this piece is done. We'll be able to connect 1.5 inch PVC pipe on this end. So this is the fitting that's gonna go into my Hayward pump. I'm gonna put a little bit of thread tape on it. I'm going to thread this all the way in, nice and tight, and then give it a little extra with some pliers. Alright, so the next part I'm going to do is I'm going to actually glue this piece into the custom piece we built earlier, but I'm gonna have to slide it in just far enough to line up with where our other pipe will be eventually. So this will be up here, there'll be a short piece of pipe between these two, a piece of pipe here that goes into this union, and then a piece of pipe on the other side of the union that goes into the fitting connected to the pump. So all of this is going to be about alignment at this point. I've got to cut pieces of pipe to go between each of these to create this shape where we can remove it at this end, and we can also remove it at this end because we've got this union in place here at the pump. So our union's going to go on that, and it's all going to line up with this. Okay, we're nearly there. Just need to cut one piece of pipe that will go in between these two elbows. I'll probably remove this side that goes into the sand filter, fit that piece of pipe in here, and then slide it in here. Looks like this will work out. I'll show you the finished product here in a few minutes. Here's the final product. Got our custom fitting we made with a nut from our old flexible hose. Got a union on this end in case we need to remove the pump. And it's 1.5 inch PVC all the way around. So I hope this helps you if you're thinking about tackling this yourself. I'll leave detailed description and notes for the various parts I used, especially this union, with some links. Please like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks.